Duke always to squeeze the two handles at the sides. For safety, to block the cross. We will now do a demonstration with the new Type 7 ton Maxx vertical lock screw. We will show now how to set the pipe control rod on this machine. Find the height you need. One hand on the handle. Turn off the switch. Loosen the black nut. Pull up the rod to the height it will come up to. Squeeze the black nut. Turn on the machine. And we'll stay there. We will now put on the split wedge. This slides easily over the main axis of the machine. The purpose of this is it splits fresh timber to pass much easier. We will now turn the plastic nut and the machine will automatically go back up to full height, because in this case we are using longer logs. It's important always to squeeze the two handles at the sides. Quite sticky for safety. We will now move it to the second position of the log table. I'll just highlight the size of this log. It's approximately 27, 28 inches long. often practice after splitting during the ear cuff, bring down the axe to the very last. Just on your two handles. Come off the machine. Go to the back, loosen the black plastic nut. Pull off the steel rod to the last, the height control rod. Squeeze the black plastic nut. What this does, it ensures in the morning that when you start the machine cold, that the axe can go back up to the last. Pressure on the hydraulic system. It's very important to let these machines run for 3 to 4 minutes in the morning while they're cold, so the hydraulic system can warm up. This ensures no damage to the hydraulic system. We will now turn the black plastic nut in the back, just to show when you do this in the morning, after the 3 or 4 minutes, the axle comes back up to the up position.